The sound of a fight. Father has spoken.
Medina,
or good afternoon, Medina,
or good evening, or whatever time you're watching this. And attention students, any boy or girl interested in running cross country next fall, the cross country coaches will soon be sending out information regarding cross country season for next fall. This information will include summer training. If you did not run cross country last year but are interested, please email Coach Olson if you're a girl, or Coach Dudek for boys. If you ran last year, we already have your contact information.
And you know, Gigi, I've just been really bored. I wish that I had just like five different ways that I could cure my boredom. Just five, though, you know? Too. And I think I actually found a video that Delaney put together with five things that I can do to cure my boredom. Do you want to see them?
Oh, yeah. That sounds great.
To you, Delaney.
Returning books and retrieval of personal locker belongings will begin Tuesday, May 19th. As you can see from the graphic, the dates and times are divided by last name. The school's number one priority is the safety of our students and families. So we have come up with the following plan. All students will enter the building through the D4 north entrance doors. Pallets will be set up in the senior commons, separated by subject area. Bins for spring sports will also be set up in the senior commons for students to drop off uniforms.
Students will enter the building and move quickly to the senior commons, where they will place their textbooks on a proper pallet, and if they have uniforms, will place them in a sealed bag in the appropriate bin. Seniors will follow the procedure, but additional pallets will be placed in the senior commons, where the seniors will drop off their Chromebooks. After placing their textbooks on the proper pallet, and if necessary, returning athletic uniforms, students will move immediately to their locker if needed to remove their personal items and clean out the lockers. Students will remain socially distant and will not congregate in the common areas and exit the building through the D6 door next to the ISR room. Once they have completed dropping off their materials and cleaning out their lockers.
Returning all my books for the last time makes me think about all my years at high school.
Yeah, man. Those are some good times. Well, here are some of my friends that are also seniors who have their favorite MHS memories.
My name is Nick Bauer. My favorite high school memory is probably going to all the encore competitions. Go Bees, nothing runs like a deer.
Hello, my name is Dom Ray, and my favorite memory of high school was playing baseball.
Hi, my name is Jacob Matthews, and I think my favorite high school experience definitely had to be everything to do with hanging out with my friends. From football games to school trips, all of that, they were just all super fun, and with my friends being there, it just made it even better. So I definitely have to say my favorite high school experience or experiences was definitely just hanging out with my friends and having fun.
Hi, my name's Andrew Merrick, and my favorite memory from high school is probably performing as Marcellus in this year's fall musical.
Hi, I'm Ashley Mattis, and if I had to pick some of my favorite high school memories, it would definitely be the musicals, because I felt like I built friendships with people that I never would have before, and I always just had so much fun at rehearsal, learning dances and choreo and singing with my best friends. So those are definitely some of the memories I will remember.
Hi, my name is Katie Scher, and my favorite high school memory is meeting all of my friends before school started, because it really just put a positive start to my day.
My name is Noah. My favorite part of high school is playing tennis, because I made a lot of new friends. Hey, I'm Brad, and my favorite memories from high school have to be the tennis team dinners and tournaments, by far.
Hi, I'm Trey Smith, and my favorite high school memory was probably winning Grand Champs at Ada for our first time since 2016 with Encore. It was a super crazy moment, and honestly, like, it was just such a good payoff for all the work we had put in that season, and I got to do it with all my friends, and I'll never forget it.
So, Medina, as some of you may know, Ohio's weather is literally all over the place. First, it was 77 and sunny, and we were sunbathing, and the next, it was a snow globe outside. Hey, Riley, do you think the weather is going to be any better this month?
Honestly, I think it's going to keep snowing until July. So, are we looking forward to sunbathing on our back porches in 70-degree weather, or should we grab those snow boots back out of the basement closet to build another snowman this year? Thankfully, we have Carter Peter.
And attention seniors, on behalf of the Morning Announcements crew, we wish you the best of luck and much success as you move forward into life after high school. Remember all the memories you made here, and don't forget, once a B, always a B.
I think something I'll miss going into college is my teachers from high school. Let's go to Rowan McDonald, who interviewed Miss Foy to see what she's doing during this quarantine.
Hey MHS, I'm Rowan McDonald, and today I'm going to be spending some time with one of our amazing art teachers, Mrs. Foy. So, Mrs. Foy, what has life been like since we've last been in school?
Well, the week after break, the teachers did a lot of professional development to get ready with technology to start our lessons. And it's really difficult grading art pieces from little teeny tiny photos online, even when they're enlarged. And I'm sure it's as frustrating for the students as it is for the teachers. It's not like being in the classroom.
Yeah. Have you been working on any personal art pieces while you've been at home?
Well, so glad you asked. Behind me are two 24x30 canvases that were started a couple years ago by staff. And they were invited to each paint a flower on these canvases to decorate the downstairs white teacher workroom. And they looked pretty good, but they weren't talking to me. So I brought them home and I was looking at all these images of coronavirus, and I collaged about 50 coronavirus organisms onto the canvases, and they look awesome. And the title is called COVID-19-20 MHS seniors.
That's awesome. It looks super good from here. I love it. I know that you're involved in painted parking spots. Is there any info you wanted to tell MHS about that?
Yes. So the deadline to submit your sketches for seniors is Friday, May 15th. And you would have received a Google Doc with all the permission forms and everything you need and payment responsibilities. And they get submitted to Mr. Mike O'Brien. And we have not decided on the dates for painting yet because of everything that's up in the air. But one good thing about social distancing is that all the parking lot spots are at least every other spot. So you don't have to get close to anybody to get your painting done.
That's awesome. That's really good. So I heard that maybe you had an accident over break, or
do you want to see what I did? Okay. Yeah. Oh, wrong foot. So this is.
Oh, what happened?
I broke my foot gardening. So maybe I should have a new like name. I'm kind of klutzy now. So yeah, it's been great. Bad for walking every morning though.
Oh, well, I'm glad that you're hanging in there. And I think all the students sympathize with the teachers and how we're doing during quarantine. So it's really great to talk to you, and back to you in the studio, MHS.
I'm so tired of everything being closed because of this virus. I can't go out to eat at a restaurant with my friends. I can't go see baseball. I can't see football. The Kentucky Derby's closed. I was planning on taking a trip to the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo to get some new cows. Can't even do that. Can't go to my favorite Taylor Swift concert this summer. And worst of all, Broadway's closed. How am I supposed to go see?
Mr. Holdman.
Mr. Fernandez.
The stage in Medina, the Middle Stage Theater, still has a way that you can see this spring play.
But how?
With the power of technology. Here comes Shakespeare in Love.
Act 1, Scene 12. Shakespeare in Love. Take it away.
Look, my lady, a letter to Thomas Kent.
From who?
From the playwright William Shakespeare. He was desperate to speak to Master Kent.
Oh, I can't believe it. I have never heard my words spoken with such honesty. I am writing a comedy of quarreling families reconciled in the discovery of Romeo to be the very same Capulet cousin stolen from the cradle and fostered to manhood by his Montague mother that was robbed of her own child by the Pirate King. And I would have you play Romeo Montague, a young gentleman of Verona.
Verona again!
Is Master Shakespeare not handsome?
Oh, he looks well enough for a mountebank.
Oh, nurse, he would give Thomas Kent the life of Viola de Lesseps dreaming.
My lady, this play will end badly.
It's a comedy. It ends with a pirate's jig. And as you love me and I love you, you'll bind my breast and buy me a boy's wig. Rehearsals begin tomorrow.
Your father!
From tomorrow, away in the country for 3 weeks.
Look, there she is. This is her balcony.
Oh, great heaven.
Go on and speak to her.
I don't dare. The nurse is there.
My lady, you'll catch your death out here.
Leave me, nursey.
Believe me, this will all end in tears.
Romeo, Romeo, a young gentleman of Verona, a comedy by William Shakespeare.
Well, go on. My lady.
Who's there?
Oh, William Shakespeare.
Anon, good nurse, anon. Master Shakespeare?
The same, alas.
Why alas?
A lowly player.
Alas, indeed. For I thought you the highest poet of my esteem, and a writer of the most brilliant comedies that capture my heart.
Oh, I am him too.
Lady Viola!
Anon, good nurse, anon. I will come again.
Enough. She takes the bait. Let's go.
Nonsense. I'm just getting somewhere.
A lowly player? You're supposed to be a poet. Get out of there before you shame us all.
If they find you here, they will kill you.
And you can bring them with a word.
Not for the world. Speak to me. Inspire me.
Alas, I cannot, for I am struck dumb by your beauty.
Come, come, good poet. These are hackneyed tropes. Extemporize, improvise. Fill me with your words.
Leave.
Now?
Yes. Translate our bass song into the golden verse of love.
Thanks.
What was that?
Recite something you know.
I've gone blank.
Anything.
Help me, Kit.
Shall I compare thee?
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate.
Well, it's not exactly Philip Sidney.
Go on.
That's as far as I got.
As far as you got?
Help me, Kit.
Rough winds.
Rough winds.
Do shake?
Do shake.
The darling buds of May?
Isn't that spring?
It rhymes with day.
The darling buds of May.
And summer's lease.
And summer's lease.
Hath all too short a date.
Hath all too short a date.
Oh, this is beautiful, Will. More.
Got it. But thy eternal summer.
But thy eternal summer.
Shall not fade.
Shall not fade.
Nor lose possession of that thou fair owest.
Nor lose possession of that fair thou owest.
Nor shall death.
Don't mention death.
Death is good.
Nor shall death.
Brag thou wanderest in his shade.
Brag thou wanderest in his shade.
When in eternal lines to thine thou growest.
What does that mean?
Just say it.
When in eternal lines to thine thou growest.
So long as men can breathe.
So long as men can breathe. Or eyes can see.
Not bad.
So long lives this.
That's it.
And this gives life to thee.
Bravo.
I have it back, kid.
Oh, it's wonderful.
It's nothing, really.
Only you could have conceived such a thing.
I think it lacks something in the middle.
Not another word. It's perfect.
Madam!
I must go.
No, but I'm a poor poet. I have not had payment.
Such sublime eloquence is God's own recompense.
Yet to receive the prayers of those two pilgrims, thy lips.
Too far.
I could not sully thy lips, gilded with such golden words.
Lady, you will burnish them the brighter eloquence. Help me up, Kit.
Good sir, do not use yourself all up.
With love's light wings, did I reproach these walls?
God, ye heavy.
For stony limits cannot hold love out, and what love can do that dare love attempts, therefore thy kinsmen are no stop to me.
Very good.
Thank you.
Lady Viola!
Oh, go away!
Your father comes!
I am fortune's fool. I'll be punished for this.
Jump!
Hang on. I'm just getting the hang of this.
Ah!
Ah! All right. That's enough.
Yay!
All right.
Nice. Nicely done.
And for today's birthdays... For today's lunch, whatever you want to make. And as always, remember to
be respectful.
Be responsible.
And be ready.